he lost to Tokido in top six.
Even just looking at this week's developments, right? He fell short to VX Bao to Ken both times.
Yes, that is true. And speaking of VX Bao, we may have him next after this match here. But remember, we're in the promised land, as Ringe would articulate it. Shout out to Ringe. But this is a 3 out of 5 extended. Say, I see what you did there. I'm trying to focus here. But yes, this is an
chalk one up to Ringe on that one.
Now, like I said yesterday, no, because I didn't commentate with you yesterday, you may have heard me say it, you may have not heard me say it. One of the things I really love about Kakadu's gameplay, I really adore this, is his optimization from medium attacks.
Crouching yes,
medium punch into
no
drive
doubt.
Rush cancel, and stand medium kick into drive rush cancel, or punish counter confirms. So he really gets into that here.
I also really enjoy the placement of his OD departures too, being able to sandwich his opponents pretty consistently and forcing them to make the decision whether to drive rush or not. I think overall that expenditure of using the OD gauge against any opponent to kind of force the mistake is really, really important.
Again, I love watching, shouts to Lord Venom, I love watching Lord Venom back in the European scene, but this guy is like two tiers up from there. He's just that good to me. Oh. Starts off Sandfist, and because that was a very situational anti-air, because that looked like an empty jump from Daigo. Sandfist will always make you float regardless if you are airborne. And there we're talking about the crouching medium punch optimization. He may be able to take the round, Vicious. It's like we study these players to be able to show you guys and paint the picture for you in this lovely picturesque stage.
Didn't even have to use level one. Didn't even need to use OD as much, right? It was just a regular departure that kind of forced the situation and momentum in Kakadu's favor. Speaking of, OD Amnesia catches the overhead against Daigo, sending him back with the spike departure again. He's making him cautious about this approach, but again, it's the drive gauge war that Kakadu is looking for.
Ghouls and Goblins, Stalagmite gonna go into Chernobog, the level one, and sets up a departure again and trying to bait Daigo to doing something. He's probably looking for the driver opportunity into maybe Dragon Lash to Sandfist, but he jumps out and has so. And then here, as soon as he tried to drive rush, crouching medium punch.
Gotta be level two again. Coming, right? No, he's gonna be departure instead.
Yet.
He doesn't need it. He's looking for the chip first. Yes, sir. And it was a punish counter. I don't know what the attempt was. Perhaps maybe a mistimed parry from the side of Daigo Umehara. But either way, had he survived that, that chip damage was coming regardless because level two was in stock for Kakadu.
And immediately already starts off with EX Torbjörn into the Stalagmite and then again sets up the Purple Haze.
Ooh.
Almost got it.
Ay, 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 that hurt from downtown too, man. The roundhouse with a 2v, the fierce.
Dude, we felt that. Jumped in, no anti-air, and another Sandfist to punish the throw attempt there, and this is huge damage here, a good 30%, and that's going to be the round.
Imagine that.
Oh boy,
another character we've seen with combos into their throws, or off of their throws.
Hey, fun game. I like combos off of throws when I'm doing them.
Of course, of course. You couldn't see him put his hand up in the air as he mentioned that second part of that statement. A big asterisk towards that. Kakadu, I'm sure he feels the same. Looking to do so again. Now has Daigo in the corner yet again. It's been a one-player game. This is World Tour mode for Kakadu.
Oh, you sneaky bugger with the target combo there. Kakadu gets hit with the punish counter, and that might have been an execution blunder there from Daigo into the drive impact. And then if he gets one hit, that's going to be interdiction, and that will be the game. But he gets thrown, put in burnout.
Oh, boy.
Damn, that was an audacious throw tech there from Kakadu, but he's got a little bit of breathing space. And if Daigo whiffs anything... Oh, there you go.
The stomp on the counter and the standing. Oh, my gosh. That was actually so slick. And it's so tough. When you see that low medium kick block in Ruin, it's, you know, you try to counterpoke most of the time. But it's Kakadu with the stoppage again. Standing medium kick is such a good button for counterpokes.
See, I'll tell you something interesting about this game. Spacing drag. Well, okay, that's interesting because as soon as we started, I just saw a perfect parry, and Daigo is already sent to the corner again. My man looks absolutely bamboozled. I don't know if player two helps you. Maybe player one would have helped. I don't know.
I'm not too certain, to be quite honest with you, man. We talk about those preferences on hitbox, you know, or leverless, excuse me.
Oh, there you go.
That was cool. He was looking for it, right? The stop against the drive rush. Daigo two steps ahead. The crosscut DP, you know it.
That's actually good, though, because anti-air DPs, they do the same amount of damage as regular throws, so you take the damage and you're out of the corner.
Yeah.
Avoid a throw loop, so yeah, it's equivalent. It's fine. We'll take it.
It's not bad. In terms of the positioning, obviously, Kakadu doesn't want to spend any sort of time against Cannon jail time. It's going to be really, really tough to manage, I feel like, defensively. And of course, he's ready for the Dragon Lash. Who isn't, right?
Straight to the corner. Drive, gauge, well spent.
The block! Two overheads in a row!
My man is so brazen, but he's 2-0 up. He can do whatever the hell he wants here. Amnesia going to get punished.
Number one? No, the back dash.
That was rude. Nice perfect parry there on the Ix Hadouken, and he tried a perfect parry the Dragon Lash, but didn't quite work. Runs into a stand hard kick. He's gonna build the Miu time for level 3! Maybe not. Okay, he messed it up. So I'm so sorry. Here comes Lavushka. Oh my god, is he? No, he didn't avoid it. Oh, he did! Okay, he only got hit once, but you might have lost anyway.
Oh, and he dashed up into the roundhouse. Diagonal just throwing out the heavy in anticipation for the movement. But also, Kakadu, he still would have been in max range regardless.
True. But right now, Daigo is making the adaptation. This is forced adaptation, by the way. He has no choice but to win 3 games on the bounce if he wants to progress through. The winner's side of the bracket gets a throw.
Not like this. Oh, what a time to counter hit.
Drive rush speed.
Back throw. No, he just goes for the full-on punish counter to set up the departure. The burnout is there. Daigo is going to be in dire straits shortly. But, oh, that could have been huge.
Well, he went for a down forward fierce to get the sweep anyway there, did Kakaru, and then throws out the stand medium punch, pushes Daigo away to set up the bullet hell in burnout. But he's about to replenish his drive stock. Let's see what Daigo can do with it. That's going to be the game. That is the game. Coming at you. 2-1 here. Daigo making that comeback, slowly but surely, making those necessary adjustments. All right, and then the crowd quietly applauds.
Jeez, the reaction towards the OD Torbolon was everything for Daigo. Again, he treats it like a fireball. You have to essentially treat it like a fireball. From that distance, faint or not, you're still able to get that punish counter, right?
Yes, true. And he already throws out the hard kick looking for the punish counter because he wanted to take Kakadu immediately to the corner there. And they drive rush in, just slow to the punch there was Daigo. Then gets clipped by the departure follow-up. And already at 50% vitality here, not looking too good. Now your dry gauge is in trouble. You're about to lose that.
Like we talked about earlier, right? You're forcing that awkward position of whether or not to drive rush past the departure. Well, but it's Daigo spending it. If I'm going to be in burnout, I want to do it by my hands.
Do it, yeah. I 100%. If you're going to put yourself in burnout, do it by your own volition, please. You'll feel better that way, just for about 2 seconds.
2 seconds is right, as we see the chip damage. Back-to-back OD Torbolons into the spike. Kakadu looking at match point from that chip damage scenario. Again, Daigo already pretty aggressive. Kakadu might have tried to use movement as a defensive option, who knows? But it's still got the target combo. Now Daigo is in somewhat of control against Kakadu, pushing towards the corner, the roundhouse lands. The big counter put from Kakadu, get off of me, departure now.
All right, there you go, throws the fireball there, and the anti-air Shoryuken. Can you just marshal him in the corner, maybe fish for a button into drive impact if he gets the chance. But right now, Kakadu's fighting his way up. No anti-air, two last minute. Nice walk under there, no punish counter.
Aye.
But it worked out. Baited, drive impact.
Shot.
Gonna mix him up, or is he gonna go for a full combo? Looks like he's gonna go for a full combo here.
Double departure.
Oh,
no,
that's
Daigo
it.
Just gets
yeah,
with
that's
it, wrong.
It. I'm sorry, that's it. He's done. He's done. That's the whole combo. Full optimization into interdiction, making it 3-1 here for Kakadu over Daigo Umehara.
Man, there's one thing you need to do against the beast, and that's to take care of business with him early. 3-1 could have been a whole different story had Daigo been able to maybe hold out a little bit longer past that whole situation in the corner. But it's Ibushigan.
Oh. Yes, out of respect.
Kakadu.
The bow, that double handshake as well.
You already know.
He said, that's right, I don't like you, Ken, but I like you, though.
Yeah. I gotta say, man, anybody really can flinch when it comes to OD departure in the corner. But we're gonna get the full.